Hello, my dear friends. My name is Alberto. Welcome to this episode of AMP for WordPress. In the last episode, we learned about how the capabilities of the App Web Components library can help us attain the desired Core Web Vitals thresholds and page experience guarantees that are so important for our success. In this episode, we ask the question, what does it take to incorporate AMP content publishing into a content management system? Content management systems are a very popular way to create and publish web content, and there are many options available out there to choose from. In fact, today, about 60% of all sites are powered by some form of CMS. And the key reason behind such popularity is that CMSs provide layers of abstractions on top of the open web, making it much easier for everyone to tackle the complexity of web content creation, management, and publishing. We want to understand how AMP can be integrated into the standard publishing mechanism of a CMS. And we are going to do that on WordPress. Functionality in WordPress can be added in two ways. Either we incorporate it as part of the core of the platform, what is usually referred to as WordPress Core, or we build an extension expanding the core capabilities of the platform. These extensions are usually referred to as plugins in WordPress lingo. Now, WordPress Core is reserved for the fundamental capabilities of WordPress as a CMS. Therefore, integrating AMP content publishing into the platform must be done via the development of an AMP plugin. The process of enabling AMP for WordPress can be mapped into a functional spectrum with two extreme scenarios. On one end, everything is done manually. The site owner bears the full responsibility of executing on all aspects involved in adopting AMP when building their site. This scenario is very challenging and virtually out of reach for most of us. And on the other end, everything is done automatically. Site owners can just flip a switch and AMP content is generated and maintained with ease for their whole site. This is the ideal scenario, because here, users can take full advantage of AMP superpowers regardless of their technical ability or the resources they have. So what we need then is to have a plugin which implements the functionality for enabling AMP content generation in WordPress. And as this plugin evolves, the balance point between the fully manual and fully automated scenarios is going to be moving progressively towards full automation. Now, WordPress is a complex CMS, and the process of generating and serving web content involves many steps. But in the context of building extensions for the platform, the key aspect we need to be aware of is the plugins API. This API works in terms of hooks, which defines specific entry points into the execution path WordPress follows when serving URL requests. Each of these hooks can be associated with different code blocks, what we usually call functions. Then, when the event associated with a given hook is triggered, all the functions that are associated with it are executed, possibly with different priority levels. There are many hooks available. As of version 5, WordPress supports over 2,000 different hooks. And we can also create custom hooks so that other extensions can integrate with ours as needed. So, AMP content generation in WordPress means having a plugin which does two things. It inserts functionality at specific points, the hooks, to influence the content generation process and output AMP-compatible markup when possible. And it performs additional processing tasks on the output generated by WordPress in order to ensure that the generated content is fully valid AMP. The official AMP plugin for WordPress, developed by contributors to the AMP project, does exactly that. Specifically, the plugin implements functional capabilities that can be grouped into four main areas. First, the plugin internalizes the AMP HTML specification and effectively becomes a WordPress embedded AMP validator. This functionality is then used to ensure that the generated markup is valid AMP, and if there are validation issues, detecting which errors are occurring and exposing that information precisely to users. Second, in WordPress there are several ways to generate content, such as embed, shortcodes, widgets, blocks, and so on. These are triggered during the part of the overall content generation process referred to as template rendering. The AMP plugin hooks into this content generation mechanism and produces uncompatible content instead. But although there are many entry points available to hook into, there are parts of the generation process that cannot be reached during the template rendering phase. To deal with these cases, the plugin captures the results of the template rendering phase into an output buffer, and it then parses it into a DOM document and performs a set of processing and conversion tasks. And after all this generation processing is over, then we end up with generated content that may or may not be valid AMP. And depending on the outcome, the plugin then triggers different serving strategies aimed at minimizing the likelihood of publishing invalid AMP content and ensuring that users get the best experiences when accessing our site. This gives us a general sense about the approach to extend the capabilities of WordPress via extension. The use of such an extension to incorporate AMP content publishing capabilities into the platform, and the AMP plugin for WordPress as an instance of a plugin that implements these functionalities. In the next episode, we will discuss how to get started with AMP in WordPress using the official AMP plugin. So stay tuned, don't forget to click the subscribe button and enable notifications, and let's make it happen.